beautiful one was called, what was it called? It's on my notes here. First Thought, Best Thought. It's one of my songs, but he came up with a beautiful little guitar riff on it, and our bass player Thomas was playing a really languid kind of rolling bass line. So, you know, we did that one. We did another one. We did a fast one called Lifelong Dream, where the drums were, you know, the star. So that's how we kind of did our first recording. I mean, we just put that out as the Lifelong Dream digital single with two bonus tracks.
Oh, got it. Okay. But so how long
that was kind of how that worked. Yeah.
How long has how did Even Glass come about? How long has that been an act?
We started, I mean, I guess this was 2019. So
right before the COVID, right? Yeah, in the before times.
It was because I met up with PJ. We had a lot of common musical influences, and then circled back with Thomas, who I had chatted with before, and then we got together once or twice, and then we found Chris, who's an amazing guitar player too. And you know, we did that, and then we put those out, and we actually got the Noise Pop Festival in San Francisco.
Uh-huh.
And that was on actually my birthday, February 28th, 2022, like a week before COVID.
Right.
And that was our first gig. So
oh, wow.
We played it, and then we couldn't see each other for, you know, a year
right.
and a half or whatever it was.
Wow. Did you stay connected online and try to write songs and do the things that everybody was doing?
Well, that's what I was kind of doing next. Like, I had the original batch of songs I wanted for this band, but then, like I said, being inspired by my friends and my friends in this band, it gave me something to write for. So I could write, so there would be room for Chris to play something beautiful. There'd be room for Thomas to come up with a bass line and PJ to drive the song. So that's kind of what I did during that time. I had, you know, a batch of six songs. So once we were able to get back together, we recorded those, and we put that out as an EP.
Got it.
The Steady Motion EP.
Uh-huh. So it seems like little batches of tunes at this
point.
Yeah,
so the next thing will be, you know, come up with another 10 or 12 songs that fit kind of together and do it that way.
What genre would you describe that band? Is it more of a rock band? It's more of a rock band, I'm thinking.
Band, yeah.
I mean, you're playing electric instruments and...
Yeah, I just call it indie rock.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if like the Pixies or something like that would be a influence for that kind of music.
Yeah, indie rock's a broad umbrella. You really don't know. I used to go out to Huchica. I don't know if you ever did to those shows.
That's,
out there.
Yeah, another huge inspiration for me.
Oh, was seeing some. You know, I used to when Jeff started putting that show together, I was like, who are all these bands?
Yeah.
And I go out there and I'm like, well, God, these guys are really good. I mean, I saw Starcrawler there last year.
Okay.
Holy cow.
Yeah.
I mean, they're touring arenas now.
Yeah.
Arrow to Wild is their lead vocalist. And I've seen some of the acts that were there 2 and 3 years ago that are, they're doing late night. They're playing late night shows, you know, and these were bands I guess there's a whole following of that whole genre.
When he started doing that, like one of the first bands was Fruit Bats. And
that's who it was. I think that's his other band, the Fruit Bats guy.
He has a folk band.
Something with a V. I'm thinking. Anyway, I saw them.
Vetiver,
it was like
maybe?
Yeah, Vetiver. Yeah. Yeah, they were on like Letterman or something or you know, one of those.
So, yeah, I thought, man, this is catered just for me, like for living
right.
here in Sonoma. Like,
right.
This is the kind
this
of
is my music
like.
Festival.
Yeah, definitely.
So if that festival were to come around again, playing there would be something.
Oh, would
Evening
be
Glass
yeah.
would rule. We're going to take a quick break. We are here live in the studio with Zach Carroll from Evening Glass. We're going to hear a little bit more about that, and we're going to hear a little bit more from him right after, in a perfect world, a word from our sponsors.
Programming for KSVY is brought to you in part by The Schoen Group, located in beautiful downtown Sonoma. SchoenGroup.com. This health moment is brought to you in part by Sonoma Valley Hospital.
Scientific research has shown that forgiveness is good for our health. It can help us mentally, emotionally, spiritually, and physically. People who hold on to grudges and grievances and who tend to blame others for their problems have more physical illnesses than those who don't. You can bring greater peace and harmony into your life by choosing to forgive. Remember that forgiveness always starts with ourselves. This means taking responsibility for your hurt and then releasing it.
It's supposed to say, and now back to the new old show with James Marshall Berry, and it has a gong. And then I come in and go, hi, and we're back. So that's where we're at right now. Right. We're back live in the studio with Zach Carroll from Evening Glass. We're talking a little bit about how that band got together, what they're doing. So that band is gigging out pretty much, right?
Or do you have it? We just played. I mean, we played the Starling. We played in.
Oh, you did the Starling. Okay.
Parkside in San Francisco. We just played the Napa Valley Distillery.
The old right there on the edge of the river, right? Isn't that the?
This one's
I'm trying to figure out where it is because it was
the
Stone House
District. That used to be Stone over there, but. No, this one's kind of down off of 29.
Over the bridge and make off of Soskal and the industrial
it's
area.
It's not as far as Soskal.
Oh, got
closer
it.
Closer to 29, but
okay.
That guy Damien is the booker there, and he's trying to put on original music, so no cover bands and that kind of thing. So
right.
He's trying to make a little scene there, and
I've seen a lot of acts play there. He's getting it out on social media. I keep seeing Napa Distillery.
Yeah, and it's a fun room. Yeah.
So what gigs do you have coming up with that act?
Well, we don't have anything on the books right now. I was talking to Fred at Starling about coming back sometime in the fall or winter, but we haven't picked a date yet for that.
Right, right.
We'll be doing that.
And what about you solo? Nothing in the works either coming up?
No, I mean, I'd rather play with the band.
Yeah. I hear that.
I used to play a lot, like Epicurean Connection. Sean's place, solo.
Well, that was right down on where Psy is, I think, right?
Yeah,
along, right around there.
So I've done solo stuff like that, but I like playing with the drummer and the guitars and that kind of thing.
Well, now what kind of rig do you use when you play with the band? I mean, what are your electric guitars?
I have a Les Paul.
Right.
Yeah.
As one should.
I've actually been told I went to get it set up in Petaluma, and I've been told, "Oh, this isn't a Les Paul." And I go, "Well, it's still a guitar." He thought it was counterfeit era. So.
Really?
Yeah.
It has Gibson on it, and
you
didn't think it was.
But I bought it in, I want to say 1995 for $250. So I'm not surprised that it's.
In 95, Les Paul. I bought mine, my 71 in. About that time, and it was $400.
Yeah.
I mean, Les Paul, until Slash made things really,
Yeah.
I mean, Slash took Les Pauls from $400 to $4,000 overnight.
I was telling you, this wire shouldn't be this color and whatever, and I was like, okay, well.
This wire?
he knew all the signs of how to tell it was counterfeit. So I'm like, well, it's all right. It's still a guitar, and it's still
Well,
rocks,
you know, I have a Chinese knockoff of a blonde Telecaster. That's just, I paid literally $165 for this thing. And it says, Fender Custom Shop and all this stuff. And it has saddles that don't tune exactly. But this guitar, it has a certain level of jankiness that, it plays just fine.
Yeah.
They all
have their own personality.
They all do. And whether you bought a $5,000 Telecaster or a $50 Telecaster, if it's what you like and what you it plays well for you and it does the things you need it to, does it really matter? I mean, Sears Roebuck and Montgomery Wards were making guitars and selling them, with cardboard amps, and people made amazing recordings with those things in the 50s. So get on to the song for us.
Sure.
We're here live in the studio with Zach Carroll talking about this and talking about that. What's the name of this one?
This one will be Down, Down, Down. And this one has a funny influence. It was when I was coming up with the progression, I thought, this is a kind of like a Gordon Lightfoot little thing. Hey, but I don't really sing it like that, so we'll see how it goes.
We'll see how it goes. Zach Carroll right. Live in the studio.
This one's called Down, Down, Down. Try to disguise another lonely night. Oh, why? Well, all right, I'll hide another quiet night. Can you feel it slipping down, down, down? Can you feel it spinning round? Can you feel it slipping down, down, down? Can you feel it spinning around? Up on Highway 49, living high under the pines. Now I'm up off Highway 12, mostly keeping to myself. And that's why I try to describe another lonely night. Oh, why? Well, all right, I'll hide another quiet night. Can you feel it slipping down, down, down? Can you feel it spinning around? Can you feel it slipping down, down, down? Can you feel it spinning around? Once upon a time, would you be my Valentine? Happens each and every time. Now I got something in my eye, and that's why I try to disguise another lonely night. Oh, why? Well, all right, I'll hide another quiet night. Can you feel it slipping down, down, down? Can you feel it spinning around? Can you feel it slipping down, down, down? Can you feel it spinning around?
Zach Carroll live with us in the studio in the new old show here on 91.3 KSVY-FM Sonoma. If you have just tuned in, or if you tuned in a while ago and you're going, God, I wish I would have tuned in sooner. Well, you can. You can point your browser to ksvy.org soon after this show ends and grab the audio podcast by pointing by finding my show. If you go to Wednesday, the drop-down, it has shows, and you hit the drop-down, it has Wednesday, and you click on the Wednesday. And then all the Wednesday shows show up, and I'm in there. So if you click on the new old show, you'll get to my profile page, which I probably has a picture of me wearing the exact same hat and a black T-shirt, looking my best to look like Wayne. And yeah. Then you can go to the our Spotify podcast network there. So what are the plans for the band, as it were? I mean, you mentioned you have a daughter. So, right. I mean, touring in a van is probably out of the question.
No, I mean, it's really, you know, it's a practice for me. Like, people have a yoga practice. It's music. It's what, you know.
Oh, got
it. It's my hobby. It's what I like to do. So we'll hopefully record some more songs. We'll play gigs. We'll play in town. We'll play in the city maybe again.
Yeah.
That kind of thing. Maybe some, like a festival kind of thing would be great for us because,
yeah,
you know, you want to bring out a crowd of people. that's the dream.
Yeah, yeah. There's nothing like playing to a big group of people, yeah, that all are digging you.
Yeah.
How do people find out more about you and Evening Glass? Are you combined in the one, or is there a profile, you know, with the Spotify and the music
I'd
and all that?
I probably have some solo stuff up there still, too, just under my name, Zachary Carroll. But, yeah, I'd say go look for Evening Glass. Look for us on Instagram, on Bandcamp, where we have stuff
Spotify. Bandcamp, right.
Yeah, Bandcamp. That's where you can get the downloads and that kind of stuff. And
then
I'll have links to, you know, all our reviews and our features. We were lucky enough when we put out that EP last year, we got a pretty good feature on a website called Janglepophub. And
wow.
We made their number 4 of the top 10 EPs of the year on that. So we're finding little audiences here and there, but it, you know, it's a matter of trying to bring it all together.
Yeah, exposure.
Yeah,
you're dying for it or dying from it. One of the two. It's never one or the other. Yeah. You know, we're about out of time, but we got time for one quick one. You got one more short song left?
Yeah, sure.
And this one, no capo for this
one. Okay, this was the request.
Oh, thank God we got it in.
To my buddy Jeff, this one's called Lifelong Dream.
It's for you, Jeff, here on 91.3 KSVY-FM Sonoma.
it's okay with me. I'm swimming in a mountain stream. Do you know what I mean? I'm living a lifelong dream.
Zach Carroll here on 91.3 KSVY FM Sonoma. Now, I'm thinking that was a rock song that we just from the bar chords. It's kind of gave me away. That would be one the band would play, not something we would typically play on acoustic.
I think we play all the ones I played today.
Oh, really?
We kind of rock them up a little more.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Okay. Well, hey, man, I really appreciate you taking the time to be here. It's nice getting to know you a little bit more.
Yeah.
People want to find out more about Zach. You can look around for Evening Glass. I mean, you might even want to type in Evening Glass Sonoma if you're doing the Google, because that'll get you a little closer. Thanks for coming in, man. We will catch you. We'll look around for your act, and this time we'll try to get there on time.
All right. That's a deal. Thank you.
I have been your host, James Marshall Berry. You've been listening to 91.3 KSVY FM Sonoma, the new old show. Stick around. Next week we have the one and the only Jamie Clark coming into the studio. So if you've not heard or met Jamie, next week will be your chance.